Hey there, my WebCrafting Wizards. Have you ever wanted to create a fun, interactive 3D website? Well, it was quite hard to do, but with the tools these days that we have now, it's actually pretty easy. So we're going to be using a no-code editor like Wick Studio and Spline to create this awesome animated character that dances around, and your mouse actually controls the lighting of the scene. So let's get into it. Let's rock and roll. So we're gonna head over to Maximo, and this is a fantastic place if you want to create any sort of interactive characters in 3D. And if we go to animations at the top here, as you can see, they have a large library of different types of animations, from punching to swinging to dancing to, oh, you don't want to know what else is going on here. But in this case, we want a dance, so let's pick one. Locking hip-hop dance. This kind of looks the way I dance, to be honest. There we go, so that's the animation. And now that we have the animation, what we want to do is attach a 3D character to it. So you could upload your own if you want. You can head over to like Turbo Squid if you're interested in getting something custom, or also Sketchfab is a popular one. But in our case, there are a couple of preset characters that we can use straight here in Maximo. So we're just going to do that. And if we head over here, I'll just delete the search, and look at that, there's quite a couple. I think I just searched dance here, and there we go, we have Michelle popping up. So let's click on Michelle, and there's our character animating. Wonderful. Now we're gonna hit download, and here for the format, we are gonna select FBX binary. The frames per second we're gonna set to 60, so it's nice and smooth, and we are gonna select width scan and hit download. Perfect. Now that we have this downloaded, we can head over to Spline, which is a fantastic tool to create 3D animations in the web. You can hit new file here at the top to create a project. And now that we're in the project, we can drag in this wave hip hop dance right here in the center. And there it is. Now, as you can see, there's no texture to it whatsoever. If I click on this icon here, that's the light. And if I move it around, as you can see, that still works just fine. For some reason, Spline doesn't detect the textures on this FBX. So I'm gonna upload the textures image in the video description. So have a look there, download it. And once you have it downloaded, you can just come here, click on the image in the materials tab. And then we are gonna just search for that image that we uploaded. There we go, I attached the texture, and there we go. We can close everything up now. And as you can see, if we move the light as well around, it reacts to it nicely. If you want to modify the light here, you can head over to this tab. If you want to change up the color of it maybe, or the intensity, you can do it all from this panel right here. All right, I'm gonna leave it at default. I think that looks pretty good. Now what I want to do is have this light follow my mouse. So I'm gonna click on the light, head over to events here, and I can attach a follow event. So if you scroll here, find follow, and we are going to target the cursor. All right, so it always follows the cursor. Hit play and have a look. There we go. Now what we can do is just export this. So we're going to head to export, we're going to head to viewer, and all we need to do here is just copy these two script tags here, which we can embed in our no code editor. In the play settings, you can also disable unhover, orbit, pan, zoom, and etc. All right, so no one can actually touch the, you know, because when you're in play mode like that, I can actually rotate and move this around if I want to, and you don't want anyone to do that on your website. So we'll disable that right here. So now I'm in Wick Studio. We are going to hit add section here, and I'm just going to open up the left panel here and drag in an iframe. So here I can just enter the code and paste in that spline viewer. So there's our 3D character, and now we are just going to stretch this out all the way. Perfect. Let's take this section, and maybe I'll just bring it a tad bit in just so it kind of touches her feet. So now that we have our character, if we look in preview mode, this is actually going to already react to the light. So there we go. How cool is that? And how simple it is to just pop it into Wick Studio and you are done. So background, let's head over to color. We're going to choose gradient, and we're going to switch it over to radial, just like that. And for the first value here, we're going to do a gray, and the second value here is going to be black. So let's pick black like that. That's pretty cool already. If you want to keep it like that, feel free to add like a tint of color to it as well if you want. All right, so let's also add the title. We're gonna do a special one for this one. We're gonna head over to text, and we're gonna do a text mask. So let's drag this text mask out here, and this is gonna be our title, and the music application that we're creating is called Wave. So let's name this Wave like that. There we go. And we can change this background wave effect here because it looks quite, it's just a bit too blue to be, I don't know, but that's okay. We can just head over to the image here and select it. And look at that, we have everything built in, so we don't need to worry about anything. Just search Wave and pick the one you like. I kind of like this one. I feel like something like this that's a bit subtle is gonna actually work much nicer. Let's also add a heading 2 here. We're gonna place it right below. We're gonna change the font and the color as well. So I'm gonna pick white. We're gonna position this to the center. I'll just bring it a tad bit in, and we are gonna rename this to High Fidelity Music Streaming. There we go. I'm also gonna bring this text up a tad bit, and I'm also gonna add a line just here to separate it from my main paragraph here. So let's head over to Quick Add. We'll do a line. We'll bring this up to the middle, and I'm also gonna make it a tad bit thicker. I also added some text here, so I'll just change the color again to a light gray. And I don't want this to be a heading, I want this to be a paragraph. So I can go to the HTML tag here and change it to a P tag. Like, I'll also take all the text and center it in the middle, and I'll give it a tad bit of line height. And finally down here, I'll just add the 2 call to action buttons. So we're gonna head over to buttons. We are gonna drag in the styled start button, start now. Let's drag it there. And we can just pick a primary color for us. If you wanna make a little design system, feel free to do it here. Now let's duplicate that and also make a secondary button. So Control C, Control V. And we'll just make this a secondary button. So I'll change it to a gray for the background. Perfect, the next step is to add some animations to the text. So let's select Wave. We'll head over to the interaction tab at the top, and on entrance, we basically want this to reveal itself. I'll just bring down the distance a bit so it's not too intense. So let's do it to like 40, and the duration for 1.4 seconds. All right, and we'll also add a tad bit of delay, like 0.2, and let's hit preview. Okay, that might be a tad bit too slow. The distance I'll also bring up to 50, and let's bring this to like 1.2. That's much better. Lovely. Let's try it with 100. Actually, you know what? 100 looks the best, to be honest. Okay, we'll keep that, and we'll do the same for our second H2 here. So we'll select slide, but the difference is I'll add a tad bit more delay, so 0.3 for this one. And then for the line here, I'm going to add 0.4, but it's gonna be a different one as well. So let's find a... I think there's a nice, like, it kind of looks like it's drawing itself. So I'm just looking for that one. There it is, shape. Let's select shape, go to adjustments, 0.3 on this. And then we are going to apply it to all the elements. And for the buttons, to be honest, I like to just fade these in after everything is done or about the same time. So I'll just do a fade for this, and I'll do around 0.5 seconds. And there you go, you are finished. You can hit preview to view your amazing website with a cool 3D animation. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know down in the comments if you want to see more interactive 3D videos like this, because they're really fun. All right. Until next time, peace out.